5th presentation of today, power system protection session, is titled Speeding Up Phase Comparison Line Protection by Means of TDQ-Based Current Unbalance Analysis. And presentation will be given by Marianne Almeida. She is an energy engineer graduated from University of Brasilia. She's currently a master's student in the electrical engineering course at University of Brasilia, where she develops scientific research in the area of electrical system protection. We will have a video for this presentation and the Q&A afterwards.
Hello, everybody. Thank you all for the virtual presence and for the opportunity. My name is Marianne, and I will present the paper Speeding Up Phase Comparison Line Protection by Means of TDQ-Based Current Unbalance Analysis. The authors are me, Marianne de Almeida, and Professor Felipe Lopes. So the transmission lines consist in the system equipment most prone to disturbance due to external causes. Thus, the transmission line protection system must be fast and efficient in order to isolate the fault quickly, safeguarding the protected equipment. Because of this, many studies have been conducted around the world in order to reduce the tripping time of transmission line protection functions, which has brought several benefits. About the time domain protections, this function is high-speed one because it eliminates the need for phase analysis, and the phase comparison protection is an example of a protection that may be implemented in time domain. The PC provides unit protection of transmission lines and no need for transmission line parameters setting calculations required, being this a potential of the PC protection. The article goal is speeding up time domain phase comparison line protection through using PAX transformation, the TDQ, to the input signals. Well, about the PC protection principles. The principles are based on analysis of angular difference between the current signals measured at the local and remote terminals of a given transmission line. And the polarities are determined by CTs, which are the current transformers. So, current entering the line are positive and current leaving the line are negative. For example, in an internal fault, we have this situation. Both current, local, and remote ones are entering the line. Then the angular difference between them is ideally zero, but in real cases is almost zero because of the lag caused by the capacitive effect of the line. And when we have an external fault or normal system operation, we have this situation. One current is entering the line and the other is leaving the line. So they are ideally in counterphase, but in real cases, the angle between them is almost 180 degrees. Then these angular differences can be used to characterize an internal or external fault. About the proposed PC protection, the proposed solution is based on PC protection principles using as input signals the direct axis components obtained by applying the path transformation, the TDQ, on phase signals. The proposed one is called PC TDQ protection and results in tripping time shorter than traditional PC protection. About the path transformation, the TDQ allows the analysis of voltage and current through reference axes that rotate at the same angular frequency of the system. Here we have a figure showing the reference axis called direct and quadrature axis and the axis of the phase signals, phase A, B, and C. The direct and quadrature axis component are calculated by this equation where PDQ is the PAX transformation matrix, and this other matrix is the matrix of three-phase signals. Well, the application of TDQ will be in current signals, so the direct and quadrature axis components are now called ID and IQ. So applying TDQ to the current signals, synchronizing the reference axis at the same omega, this signal is obtained. We can verify the component have information about the angle theta I in their argument, which carries the current direction information in the system. So, this allows the fault classification between internal and external fault via PC protection. Here, the quadrature axis component is verified the same. Okay? So, in case of steady state power balance system, the amplitude of the signal is the same, and the synchronizing the reference axis in the frequency of the system, we have as a result direct and quadrature axis component constant. And making delta theta equal to zero, the direct axis component will be equal zero. So in steady state and balanced system, okay? On the other hand, in case of unbalanced system, but without frequency deviation, note that the component is not constant as in case of steady state, but it oscillates with frequency equivalent to twice the system fundamental frequency, 2 omega. And the directionality information is still maintained. And the same is observed for the quadrature axis component, 2 omega and direction. Okay, so in the unbalanced system, the components are not constant, they oscillate with 2 omega, and they allow the identification of current directionality. Then it is possible to apply the fundamentals of the PC protection, and as the signals oscillate in 2 omega, it is possible to use a lower threshold and consequently a shorter tripping time. Well, when a fault occurs, a DC level superimposes the oscillating component. So, to eliminate this, it is proposed to calculate the derivatives of the signals in order to eliminate the DC offset from the fault signals. And for the story performed, we use only the derivative of the direct axis current, knowing that the quadrature axis current would result in the same conclusions from the protection point of view. So this figure presents the signals resulting from TDQ when an internal fault occurs. Here we have the direct axis component, and here the derivative one. And it is noticed that in an internal fault, the signals are in phase as expected, okay? On the other hand, in external fault, the signals are in counterphase. And here we have the direct axis component, and here the derivative one. About the time domain application, after obtaining the derivative direct axis component, the modulation of local remote signals is performed. In this modulation, consider half cycle approach, the positive half cycle results in high logic values, and the negative half cycle in zero values. After obtaining the modulated signals, they are preceded by an end logic gate. At pre-fault steady state, or in case of external faults, the pulses resulting from the end gate output are narrow, whereas becomes wider during the occurrence of internal fault. Thus, to analyze the width of generated pulses, counters are used to account the pulses' width in high logic level, and then the tripping signal is given when the counter reaches a threshold defined by an eighth of a fundamental cycle for PCTDQ and a quarter of a fundamental cycle for the traditional one. And to apply the full cycle approach, the positive is also accomplished. The negative half cycle results in high logic values, and the positive half cycle is zero values. And then, as before, the modulation, the end gate, and the counters. So, in order to highlight the benefits of the PC-TDQ proposed, in addition to the comparison with the traditional PC function, comparison of the PC protection using sequence components was also performed. So, a mix of current composed by negative and positive sequence components was used, where I1 is the positive sequence component, I2 the negative sequence component, and K the aiding factor. So the test power system analyzed is a 230 kilovolt 60 hertz transmission line with 200 kilometers long. Model in distributed parameters, and this figure here shows the system model in ATP. The ATP was used to simulate fault cases varying type of fault, conceptual angle, fault location, loading angle, and fault resistance, being 3,240 simulated cases in total. So here we have the results. This figure represents a scatter plot for the cases where the protections operated, which compares the PCTDQ protection against the PCTrad and PCMix protections, tripping times, where PCTrad is the traditional PC and the PCMix is the PC protection based on sequence components. Considering the line with 45 degrees plotted in the graph, one can verify that all points took place below or on the line, looking at the PCTDQ versus PCTrad. And almost all points took place below the line for PCTDQ versus PCMix, what means that PCTDQ tripping times were smaller than those of the other evaluated protections. From the scatter plot zoom, it is noticed that the highest tripping time values of the PCTDQ protection did not exceed 16 milliseconds, being smaller than one cycle at the fundamental frequency of 60 Hz. On the other hand, the traditional PC protection had values that reached almost 60 milliseconds, and some points that could not be presented here because no operation was verified. But no operation can be observed here in the cumulative tripping frequency diagram, which is possible to analyze the percentage of cases that occur for each tripping time. So we can see that the PCTDQ function has shorter tripping times and reached 100%, demonstrating that active for all simulated cases. On the other hand, the PCTrad and PCMix present longer tripping times compared to the PCTDQ. Also, the curves do not reach 100%, being 69% for PCMix and 45% for PCTrad, indicating that there are cases which the protection did not operate, right? So to better compare the functions for the same cases, simulations were also carried out with a threshold of 1/8 of a cycle for all the analyzed function. It can be seen that the traditional PC protections had a superior performance with a lower threshold, but the literature suggests the use of a quarter cycle for the functions to work safely, avoiding proper operation in adverse cases. Thus, these results prove the effectiveness of the proposed functions, showing its safety and highlighting that the TDQ approach indeed reduced the tripping time. And here, the simulations were carried out with a sampling rate of 256 samples per cycle. However, other rates can be used. In order to demonstrate this, the same cases were simulated with the emulation of different sampling rates, as you can see right here, 32, 64, 20, 128, and 256 samples per cycle. And from the results, it can be noticed that, in fact, different sampling rates can be applied. Finally, it is worth mentioning that several external faults to the transmission line with the occurrence of TT saturation were also simulated, and the traditional PC and PCTDQ did not operate in any case, proving their safety. About the conclusions, so a new approach to the PC protection based on signals from TDQ was presented. The PCTDQ reduced the traditional PC protection tripping times. The PCTDQ improved sensitivity with a loss of security and proved to be fast and reliable in all evaluated cases. So that's it. Thank you all for your attention.
Thank you very much for this presentation. So I do not see any questions in the Q&A session, but I would like to raise one question. So you have shown that there is no risk of overfunction, as external faults have not led to a tripping of this PC protection. However, you have shown that the traditional approach only operates in slightly above 50% of the cases. So what is the reason for the traditional approach, and not only to show such large operating times, but also non-operation for internal faults?
Yes, the traditional did not operate for all simulated cases for internal fault, but in external fault, did not operate in any case too. So the proposed is speeding up the traditional one, so we apply the TDQ. And then when we apply the TDQ in the traditional one, all simulated is operate in internal fault. But indeed, the traditional one no operate in several cases in internal fault. But our proposed operate. Okay.
Hello? Do you hear me?
Yes, yeah. We can hear you.
Okay. Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Felipe Lopes. I am one of the co-authors. I would like just to make an additional comment on the previous question regarding the performance of the traditional PC protection. We have to bear in mind that the TDQ proposed methodology is based on imbalances in the monitored signal. So it is so sensitive as the negative sequence components. So basically it is more sensitive than the elements that analyze phase quantities. That's why the function operated presented a better performance in some cases, especially when we consider high photo resistance or even some scenarios like outfeed in one of the monitored buses. That's it.
Thank you, Felipe, for this addition. So if there are no further questions, it's time for the last presentation.